Hey everyone, Luke here. We actually just had a rain here in Northern California that we desperately needed. And I still smell the rain. It's wonderful. But today I just want to talk about how who you are is much more important than what you do. And this concept gets lost in a lot of people today. I meet lots of young people, going to college and things like that. And they're obsessed with the end result of becoming a nurse, becoming a lawyer, becoming a biologist, all these different things, but they lose sight of who they are and how that's much more important to the world, especially at this point in history. You know, who you are has a much more profound effect on those around you than what you do, okay? If you're a doctor, but you're toxic and you're depleted, and you have bad thoughts racing through your mind, and you're not grounded, you're going to spread that to your patients, okay? It's true of a nurse, anyone in the healing arts especially, where you come in contact with a lot of people. People don't realize that anytime two people come together, there's a subtle exchange of energy between wife and husband, anyone you come in contact with your children, with your coworkers, anyone within your vicinity, especially, but even those on planet Earth, and its extension even beyond that. But more importantly, I'm talking about people within your radius, when you're with someone. And anytime, when you're with someone, you have a subtle exchange of energy. And so, like, if you're a doctor, for instance, and you're displaying a toxic, depleted energy to those around you, that affects them. Okay, the best healers are able to exchange positive energy with their patients. Okay. And that's true in any profession, okay? If you're a lawyer, if you're a real estate agent, if you're a biologist, okay? Who you are and how you exchange energy with other people is much more important than the actual thing that you are doing, okay? Because if you develop yourself, okay, and get rid of all your toxic thoughts and your toxic energies, then you automatically exude a positive influence on everything around you, everything that you touch, all people that you come in contact with, and everything that you do, okay? And your world will begin to reflect who you have become. Because to an extent, you have to realize that the world is our mirror. This is very important, okay? The world is our mirror, and as we develop ourselves, the world around us begins to change, okay? So especially in these times, people, a lot of times they get so up in their heads, right? We get so up in our heads and so worried about the national debt. We get so worried about the president, so worried about national defense, illegal immigration. We get so worried about our friends, how they're doing. We get so worried about our relatives, are they making the correct choices? We get so worried about all these things that are outside of ourselves and that we can't truly influence in any great way except to develop ourselves. Okay, so really it all comes back to you. You have to bring your energy back into yourself. Okay, and by doing that, by conquering yourself, you can help to heal the world. And this is much more important than what you do. Okay, I meet many young college students, for example, that are very, very depleted, especially I notice with the young women that are studying things like nursing and things like that. These boys and girls, they're sleeping like 5 or 6 hours a night. They're running off of coffee and caffeine and stimulants. They work hard and they're getting good grades. And the end result is they're going to get into nursing school. They're going to get into whatever college they're wanting to get into. But while they're doing that, while they're becoming that, they're destroying their bodies. Okay, and it's especially hard on the young women, I notice. And most of them never recover from that, okay? Your health is you're either getting healthier or your health is declining to an extent, okay? And, the amount that they deplete themselves, it's going to affect their children, because they're never going to recover from the amount that they've depleted themselves, okay? You can to an extent, but especially if you're on a nutritional balancing program, but, they never truly recover from that. And, it's not worth it, okay? No amount of school, this gets lost on people, no college degree, no amount of money is worth just wrecking your body for. It's not worth getting 4 hours of sleep a night and living off of caffeine and junk food and destroying yourself. Okay, it's not worth it. Okay, maybe for a very short period of time it's worth it. I think of something like going to boot camp, you know, for the army. You know, you're gonna have to put in the work, right? But any amount that you can avoid those things is possible. You know, it's not worth it. Okay, I understand the end result, but it's just, it's not worth it, okay? Like I said, who you are is much more important than what you do. And who you become is much more important than what you learn, okay? And a lot of it is the process, it's not the end result. Living in the moment, enjoying the process, okay? And that is a much better way to help heal the world. So I hope that helps you guys out, and I'll talk to you guys later.